Barbie with Mudbeak and Barbie and Sphinx is down a long lane in the county of Links, and often on Wednesdays, while harnessed and spruce, I'll drive over wheels over wind if he's loose.
A whacking great sunset, big bubbling train, from Kirby of Mudbeak to Beckby on Bay. And I saw, as I journeyed, my marketing gun, or Casey Tower, take the last of the sun. The night air nipping, and autumn is wrong, in a scent of dead cabbages down from the wall, and an ocean of silence that flooded me round, and the crunch of the wheels was a comforting sound.
The lane led so narrowly into the night, and with the bay on its left bank, the drain on its right, and feebly the carriage lamps glimmered ahead, when all of a sudden
the pony fell dead!
The remoteness was awful, the stillness intense, of invisible fenland around an immense, and out of the dark with a roar and a swell, swung hollowly thundering Speckledy Bell.
Though myself the Archdeacon for many a year,
I had not some encouragement for visiting here.
The incumbents were mostly eccentric or sad, but
the Speckledy Rector was said to be mad.
Oh, cold was the evening, and tall was the tower, and strangely compelling the tenor bell's power, as loud on the reed beds and strong through the dark, it tolled from the church and the tenantless park.
The mansion was ruined, the empty demesne was slowly reverting to marshland again, marsh where the village was, grass in the hall, and the church and the rectory waiting to fall.
And even in springtime, as kingcups about, and stumps of old oak trees attempting to sprout, fits a sinister place neither fenland nor wold, and doubly forbidding in darkness to fold.
As down swung the tenor, a beacon of sound, over listening acres of waterlogged ground, I stood by the tomb to see pass and repass the gleam of a taper through clear leaded glass.
And such lightning of life in a thunder and roar, that hearts were encouraged to hang at the door. I greater open, and sense I knew well, the dry smell of damp rot, the hassocky smell.
What a forest of woodwork in ochres and grains, unevenly doubled in diamonded panes, and over the plaster, so textured with time, sweet discoloration of umber and lime.
The candles ensconced on a high pile of pew brought the caverns of blasted bays into view, but the roof and its rafters were lost to the sight at the soul of the dark Lincolnshire night.
And high from the chancel arch paused to look down, a sign painted piece in the fight for the crown, while massive, impressive, and still as the great, a three-decker pulpit frowned over the nave.
Shall I ever forget what a stillness was there, when the bell ceased its tolling and thinned on the air? Then an opening door showed a long pair of hands, and the rector himself in his gown and his bands.
Such a fell visitation I shall not forget, such a rush through the dark that I rushed for it yet. And I pray as the bells ring over fenland and hill, that the Speckledy acres be tenantless still.